Look for the third straight Stanley Cup. Mario Lemieux is in championship form with 2 goals and 2 assists and the 6-3 win over New Jersey. New York opens up in Washington. The Adams Division playoffs pit Buffalo and Boston. Montreal skates in Quebec in the other face-off. In the North, St. Louis stole home ice advantage from Chicago. Brett Hull and Brendan Shanahan.
Stanley Cup in the cozy confines of their own igloo. Mario, fine, ready to rock, and certainly he does. Early on, though, he walks in alone on Chris Terreri, and this is a goalie's nightmare, but Terreri, quick stick work, pokes it away. Big denial right there. That would be his last. Look at the work of Jaromir Jagr. He uses the New Jersey defenseman, walks in alone, and then sets up Mario, who puts away the chippy 2-1 in favor of the Penguins. The first of 5 straight for Pittsburgh to blow this one open. Kevin Stevens, another great setup for Lemieux, and that's a Terreri eye view, and that's a big problem for the Devils goalie. 3-1, and then watch more of Jagr, number 68. There he is, lower part of your screen, cruises in, takes the setup, flips in the backhander, 6-1. Penguins at that point, they hold on for a 6-3 win. Mario had 2 assists and 2 goals here in Game 1, and Game 2 is Tuesday night in Pittsburgh, and there's no reason to think the Devils can win. After all, take a look at what Pittsburgh's done lately. Unbeaten in 19 straight games. It's been 44 days since they last tasted defeat. And if it's possible, Mario's even tougher in the postseason. It was also Game 1 in the other Patrick Division series. The Islanders at the Cap Center to take on Washington. Look at the extra effort by number 32, Dale Hunter, in front of the Islanders' net. He pokes it in, 1-1 in the third period. It's 2-1 Caps right here in the third. Michael Bavanka, the slap shot. Dmitry Kristich deflects it in. Capitals had a 3-1 lead, and that is how it would end. The Isles were 3-0 this season at the Cap Center. This was only the fourth time the Caps have won after being behind after 2 periods. Nick?
The most intense rivalry in Canada began a new chapter tonight in Quebec City. The Nordiques are in the playoffs for the first time in 6 years, proving life without Eric Lindros isn't such a bum deal. Against Montreal, the Nords faced a bitter rival and a team slumping badly. But it looks like the Canadians of Béliveau, Richard, and Geoffrion, they look great early. Quebec pulled its goaltender late in regulation, scored 2 goals inside of 2 minutes, and they're still in overtime. To Boston and the division champion Red Hot Bruins against Buffalo. Sabres and Blue led much of the game. Adam Oates then to Joe Juneau, to Cam Neely for his 2nd goal of the game. Buffalo's lead is shaved to a goal. Bruins go on to send it to OT. And then former Bruin Bob Sweeney uses the screen, takes a slapper through a maze, and wins the game for Buffalo 11 minutes and 3 seconds into a frenetic overtime period. So the Sabres steal one at Boston Garden.
The Blues stole Game 1 of the North Division on the road, and it didn't take long. 16 ticks in. Gretzky sets up Darryl Sidor. 1-0 Kings. 2nd period. Kings on the power play. Here comes Calgary's Gary Suter. Shorthanded situation. Walks in. Where are the defensemen? Nobody puts a body on him. He's in. 1-1 tie. Late in the 2nd period, the Kings scored 2 unanswered in 25 seconds. Charlie Huddy with the 2nd of the 2. They led it 3-1. Cruise from there on. The Flames were fuming with frustration. 0 for 8 on power plays. And anybody will tell you that you can't play too deeply into the playoffs without your power play clicking. Wayne Gretzky, by the way, sat out the 3rd period with a Charlie horse. He is listed as day-to-day.
Scott Young, the game winner for the Norris. St. Louis beat Chicago 4-3 in the Norris. Brett Hull, the game winner. Jimmy Carson, a pair for the Kings.
To Canada's top amateur hockey team. A century later, you can't put a price tag on the value of the Stanley Cup. The Penguins, who have 2 on their mantle, began their pursuit of 3-of-a-kind Sunday afternoon when they hosted the Devils. We take you to the igloo, and will it be another banner year? First period, Kevin Stevens off the boards. Rick Tocchet sneaks it past Chris Terreri. 1-0 Pens. Controversy would follow. Later in the period, Dave Barr in the crease ahead of the puck accidentally kicks it in. The ref, Bill McCreary, initially ruled no goal. The replay judge said it is a goal. No controversy here unless you're Chris Terreri. Mario Lemieux from Jagr, and the city's heartthrob had another big afternoon. 2nd period, Mario's Pens up 3-1. Kevin Stevens over to Mario. And Terreri commits early, and Mario makes him pay. 6-3 Penguins as they try to continue the dynasty in Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh tied the league record with their 12th straight playoff victory. Lemieux has 46 playoff goals in 50 games. He's a good one. To the stadium, the Blues and the
One-line wonders who were to be nothing tougher than first-round fodder for red-hot Boston. Causeway Street for Game 1 of them. Sabres and Boston and Cam Neely scores, and Pat LaFontaine gets hurt. Bruised his knee. They would bring him back in. 3-2 Sabres in the third. Ray Bourque trying to clear, but McGillie intercepts with a hand, drops it, and busts it past Eddie Moog. 4-2 Sabres. Bruins down. They rally to 4-3. Grant Fuhr trying to clear. Joey Junot puts it on Steve Hines' stick. The Gardener up. We're going to overtime.
Cleared to the boards, a shot, took a punch at Himalev. Kept in there by Sweeney. Bob Sweeney shoots one. He scores! He scores! Bob Sweeney comes back to haunt his former teammates as he takes the screenshot.
All right, thank you, Rick. Rick Jenneret of WJR Radio in Buffalo. Sweeney, the former Bruin, and Rick, the man who formerly had a voice. Sabres win the opener 5-4. Bruins have a habit of doing this, losing the first game of the Stanley Cup playoffs. The game two is Tuesday night in Boston. This ruined a night in which Junot had a goal and three assists, and Boston only had four goals. The Battle of Quebec open at Le Colisée. The ups and downs of Patrick Roy in the playoffs continue for Montreal. 2-1 halves, less than a minute to go in the third. Ron Hextall's pulled. It's an open at Joe Sakic. Rushes in on the right side, snaps it through the proverbial five hole. We're tied at two with 48 seconds left. Jacques Demers is annoyed. In overtime, no luck for the Canadiens. Kevin Hauer hit the post. Ryan Bellows misses the rebound on the virtually open net. Hextall was outstanding. Benoit Brunet, Nay child. Patrick Roy with some of his own heroics stops Scott Young. Late in OT, Scott Young wraps it around and beats him. Quebec has beaten Montreal 3-2 in overtime. 16:49 into it. The Nords 6-1, Lifetime versus the Habs in playoff overtime games. Matthew Schneider, though, separated his shoulder and is out indefinitely for Montreal. Canadiens only had not one power play goal in this game, but only one power play. Game two Tuesday night at Quebec. And the Smythe semis at Calgary. Playoffs mean some big hard checks. Have some sympathy for Marty McSorley. Yeah, right. Gary Roberts introduces himself. 16 seconds into the game. Wayne Gretzky in his favorite spot behind the net. Watches Daryl Sidor come in lower left of your screen. Number 25 blasts it, and it's 1-0 Kings. Great individual effort then by Gary Suter. Breaks into the left side. Cuts the Kings lead to 2-1 early in the second, beating Kelly Rudy. 25 seconds later, the slapper. Jimmy Carson is in the scramble and picks it up, puts it home, 3-1 Kings. Scary sight for the Kings. Gretzky's already out with a Charlie horse, and then Luke Robitaille gets pinned against the board, smashed head first into it by Trent Yawney. In fact, he would prove to be okay. The Kings win it 6-3, and Robitaille's fine. Calgary has not won a playoff series since they won the Cup in 89, and they just blew home ice advantage in this one. Nothing later on the seriousness of Gretzky's Charlie horse. Kings and Flames play Game 2 Wednesday. And 6 years ago to the day of the famous Isles Caps quadruple overtime.
A quick shot was blocked. Cicerelli again. Winds up, tries a high shot that was blocked by the defense. Eisenman with an opportunity in front. That went off the leg of Sylvain Lefebvre, the Toronto defenseman. Here's Eisenman between the circles. Tried to dump it across for Gallant, blocked by Krushelnicki. Mike Krushelnicki, he has three Stanley Cup rings, playing with the Edmonton Oilers in the early and mid-1980s. Lead pass for Eisenman again into the cupboard, and he holds it long enough to get the whistle from Andy Van Helleman. We drew. Wendell Clark out in front. First opportunity for the lead. Stopped by Chevalier. Loose puck in front. Picked up by Probert. He'll clear it out of trouble as Rob Pearson threw out his legs at him. Now center ice, Probert. Going to bump here with Todd Gill. Gill goes crashing to the ice. That draws a big reaction from the Joe Louis Arena crowd. And then Wendell Clark comes over.
He decks Sean Burr.
Ebrosin back behind his own net. He goes to Burr. Burr, rink-wide pass intended for Kennedy.
Gilmore out again.
Gilmore out now with Andrzejczyk. And the last change hasn't been made yet because Pearson just now getting to the bench, replaced by Borshevsky.
Here's the matchup right here. Better off on Gilmore.
Better off along the board. Got a stick on it. Chiasson pinches it. Gilmore gets by him. Konstantinov is there, and so is Fedorov. He got back to make the play defensively after it looked like the Wings may get caught. Kozlov up the board. Lead pass for Fedorov, intercepted by Rouse, and Bob Rouse flips it high in the air. It comes down right on the Red Wing blue line. Delayed offside here, but they'll wave it off as the Wings come back. Fedorov drops for Izovar. Kozlov has a man cutting in front. It was Konstantinov. It's batted out of the air. Fedorov had it knocked off of his stick. It'll be held in by Chiasson. His shot from the point right through. Hoffman, who likes to play very deep in his net, Mick.
Well, he was deep in the net that time, and I don't think he saw the shot until the very last second. He was fortunate that he was positioned correctly.
Trying to flip the defense back for Shepherd, and just a little bit too much on the pass. Now Krushelnicki takes over center ice. Into the zone, he's got Kent Baumgartner. The pass was broken up and steered to the corner by Nick Lidstrom. Now the puck comes loose behind Chevalier, recovered there by Primo. Gallant tries to make a move. Rouse poke checks him. Yzerman following the puck along the end board. Fights off with Zeselchek. Yzerman between the circles. Yzerman shoots. He scores! Red Wings lead it 1-0. And the second octopus of the playoffs makes its appearance on the Joe Louis ice.
Boy, Gallant and Cicerelli should get assists on this goal whether they touch the puck or not. Look at Gallant tying up Rouse behind the net, and when Zezel went back there and stumbled to get Yzerman, it was all over, and Cicerelli came from the other side to interrupt Lefebvre from doing anything and got away with it, and Yzerman slid it right along the ice. Stick side on Potvin and 1-0 Detroit. Reverse angle, look at it. There's Cicerelli at the bottom right. Bangs into number two. No chance for Potvin. 1-0 Red Wings.
Well, for Steve
Penalty
Yzerman.
Coming up. Excuse me, David. Penalty right off the faceoff. A high stick to the Leafs. Rob Pearson. And the Wings will get the first power play of the hockey game.
But Yzerman again has a chance. Shot just wide. Potvin came out to the top of the crease, at least to challenge that time. That's about as far out as you'll see him come. Sylvain Lefebvre has it knocked away
there
by Fedorov. Fedorov gets it from Yzerman. Fedorov spreads the Leafs out. He goes to Coffey. Coffey takes a look, sends it back for Fedorov, who immediately redirects it out to the point. Chase on shot right through. Potvin will save.
Penalty Toronto. And they're going to give him the puck. Fedorov for Coffey. They would have a two-man advantage. I don't quite understand. They're taking time off the clock. And finally, Potvin touches up.
I think what they were waiting to do there, they wanted to get the face-up in the Toronto zone with the stop and play.
Yeah. Well, it depends how long you got to waste to get it. For the 5-on-3, you're going to be lickety-split inside the zone no matter where the face-off is. Watch Cicerelli get nailed from behind. Right there, the cross-check by McCowan. And for 44 seconds that are left in the Pearson penalty, Detroit has a two-man advantage.
And two defensemen. Chiasson goes to Fedorov. Fedorov will be very calm with the puck. Passes it out to Chiasson. Takes a look. Drives a shot right through. Popper the save. Rebound. Fedorov fanned on it. And it's cleared away. Zezel. He's one-on-one against Paul Coffey. Ellett coming up. Zezel drives a shot. Chevalier. Tears it aside. Loose puck. And Chevalier had to be alert on the rebound. 20 seconds left in the two-man advantage. Here's Coffey. Enters the zone. Flips it off to Cicerelli. Late man coming. Yzerman across. And Fedorov couldn't knock it out of midair. He goes back to Coffey. Coffey to the near circle. Yzerman cross ice for Chiasson. Back to Coffey. Coffey drives a shot. Potvin the save. Rebound kicked aside to the corner. 3 seconds left in the two-man advantage. Coffey drives a shot off the glove. Potvin to the rebound sent wide by Fedorov. 1:10 now in a one-man advantage. The Leafs have one man back. Here's a shot. Deflects toward the net. And now comes to the near board. Yzerman bumping there with Pearson.
He's the second man there.
Toronto player that came out. Back for Fedorov. Fedorov goes to Ray Sheppard. Sheppard at the top of the circle. Trying to go in deep. May have hit the skate of the referee, Van Halen. Todd Gill seconds on this second penalty. Coffey centering pass. Comes all the way out to the right point. Lidstrom has it there. Moves it quickly for Sheppard. Sheppard goes back down to Lidstrom. Lidstrom to the corner for Keith Primo. Primo in front, tipped aside by Potvin. Probert now takes it to the corner. Drops it back for Sheppard. 2 seconds left in the Toronto penalty. One time by Coffey. That hit Primo. And the Leafs able to clear. So the Leafs survive as Jamie McCowan dumps it back behind Chevalier. Red Wings with a 1-0 lead on an early goal by Steve Yzerman. Here's Primo. Rink wide pass for Sheppard against Todd Gill. Sheppard drives the shot. Glove save Potvin. And he'll hang on. Probert runs into Potvin, and that draws a crowd of blue jerseys, as you might expect. Primo's got a hold of Rob Pearson. Bill Berg is there. Primo wants to be careful. He's got his gloves off, but so does Pearson have at least one glove off. Fedorov decides instead to go to the late man, Konstantina. Off of his stick, but he chases it. Yzerman checked hard by Todd Gill. Now Zezel makes a little move, slides it ahead for Gill. Right wing for Osborne. Osborne, a drop pass for Gill, moves between the circles. Gill shot stopped by Chevalier. And the penalties to Pearson and Primo have expired. Both plus.
And
for Cullen, he scores!
Nice move by Cullen.
John Cullen showed Chevalier the puck. Here it is, and then he took it away and puts in the backhander to tie the game at one.
That was a bang-bang play that came out of the far corner in a very strange bounce. And John Cullen, who was injured partway through the season, and he thought maybe he'd never play hockey again, has come back and here tied the hockey game. Bad carom off the backboards. Came out between Lidstrom and Pearson, and there was Cullen in behind everybody else. Nice fake as he put it out there. Faked it, froze Chevrolet, and went to the backhand in a 1-1 hockey game.
John Cullen scores here, but he was taken down. Puck cleared to the line by the wing defense, but not out. Todd Gill holds it in for Andrechuk. Andrechuk drops it back for Gilmore. Gilmore out to the line. Todd Gill winds up, drives a shot blocked by Konstantinov. Now Dave Ellis. Gill one times it. Did the puck. Popman came out of the net and just barely did flip it out of trouble. Ellis did not realize that Fedorov was bearing down on him. Zone. Primo holds up, got a man cutting in front, Coffee, but the pass was deflected, and Andrechuk, number 14 for the Leafs, takes over. But not for long. Dallas Drake takes him off the puck. Primo comes in with a big hit. Now Sylvain Lefebvre back behind his own net, goes to Rouse. Rouse up the boards for Borshevsky, but off Coffee, pinched in. He knocks it loose for Primo in the corner. His centering pass blocked by Rouse, who put a pretty good lick on Primo as well. And now Borshevsky gives it off to Andrechuk. Andrechuk back for Nikolai Borshevsky. He's tied up by Lidstrom. Primo comes back to get the loose puck around the board.
He ever hit. Holy smoke.
Todd Gill, nice play to Gilmore. Gilmore between the circles, back to the point. Lefebvre shot deflected wide. Here's Borshevsky, dumps it out in front. Good job by Primo on Andrechuk. And back comes Shepard with Dallas Drake, 2-on-2. Shepard's pass hit the skate of Todd Gill. Dave Bichot, that hit Gallant. He was occupied by Rouse. Now here's Gallant with an opportunity. Missed it on the short side. Bill Berg will try to hammer it out of the zone, and he gets it by Lidstrom down the for Fedorov. Fedorov takes a hit from Lefebvre. Eisenbart tried to center. Now Kozlov and Eisenbart put it behind Lynette. Lefebvre for the Leafs plays it up the board. Zezel is there, and he clears the zone.
Yeah. Simple. Toronto tries to make it in their own zone. They take everybody, grab and hold, and just try to dump it out into the mid-ice area.
Jamie McCowan goes around the glass with it, picked off by Fedorov, taken by Kozlov. Kozlov shot right through, he didn't get much on it. He took a poke at it before the whistle, and then he took a shot from a Toronto player that dumped him to the ice.
He took a shot because he went to stuff Potvin's glove, and it was big Andrechuk, I believe, that knocked him on his rear end. Big size difference there, because Kozlov doesn't weigh 165, and there it is right there, big Dave Andrechuk, 225 pounds, 6'3".
First shot, Popman went down and covered as much along the ice as he could and threw up that right pad to try to cover the high side of the net.
One thing Eisenbart could do, boy, he could smell open ice. And he saw it there, went for it, and took the pass from Kozlov, played it with a glove, down to the ice, went to the outside as McCowan stumbled. And he gave him a BC two-hander across the midsection. And Potvin just sprawled across the goal line. There go that two-hander. A cross-handed two-hander by McCowan, 33.
Yeah, here's Pearson now. Tied up by Chiasson.
Good defensive play there by Chiasson.
Back to Fedorov. His shot deflected and trickles in on Potvin, who covers up. Good creativity there.
Excuse me, David. The Leafs just don't go too far away in their own zone very often.
Looking to pull the trigger, but Racine knocks it off his stick, and that's going to do it for the first period of play. As Steve Yzerman scores for the Red Wings, and John Cullen scores for the Maple Leafs, now we have a 1-1 game after 20 minutes.
Gingerly goes to the bench.
Eldon Kennedy starting it back now as the Wings make a line change. Kennedy burst to speed, goes to Sean Burr out of his reach. Now the Leafs clear it up the board, but Paul Coffey holds it in for Detroit. Sends it in deep. Provert is there. Bounces off a check from Burr, trying to center for Kennedy. Kennedy picks it up, but his shot deflected. And Osborne, number 21, clears the zone. Coffey takes over for the Wings just inside the Detroit blue line. John Burr picks it up off the stick. Burr checked by Anderson. Here's Sheldon. Kennedy rolls it out in front. Provert trying to knock it down. Burr checks him. And the puck recovered by Doug Gilmore. Gilmore starts a rush back for the Leafs. Drop pass for Ellett. Ellett snaps a shot. Chevrolet the save, and there's no rebound there.
Oh, boy.
I think Popham may have gotten a piece of that as he came way out. At least for him, way out. The challenge Gallant. Now Osborne goes down under the pressure of Mark Howe. It's cleared up the board. Gallant is checked. Held in by Berg. His shot blocked by Mark Howe, who starts it back for Detroit. Now feeds it on the right wing. Cicerelli fakes the shot on Lefebvre. Rolls it right through the goal crease.
Potvin steered to the side. Yzerman gets to the loose puck. He's got Racine open at the line for a high drive that's over the top of the net. A sailing puck off the stick of Yves Racine. Now John Cullen has it for Toronto. Cullen into the zone. Pearson snaps it into the right of Chevalier. Picked up by Howe. He plays it off the board. Ciccarelli has it there for Detroit. Lead pass for Yzerman. He dumps it behind the Toronto net. Dmitry Mironov, number 15, to Wendell Clark. Cross-ice pass, Cullen. Carries into the zone, gives it off to Clark. Sets up for that big shot of his. Deflected off. Chevalier came out the far side. And nobody there for the Leafs to get the big rebound. Sheppard to Primo, knocked away and recovered by Cullen. Now the Leafs on the counterattack, but Cullen had it slapped away by Sheppard. The puck clears center ice. Mironov drives it back behind Tim Chevalier. Around the board, Ray Sheppard recovers. He goes to Primo. Primo tied up center ice by Pearson. Now Clark with a hit on Ray Sheppard. Sheppard, though, able to get the puck in deep behind the Toronto goal. Here is Sheppard. Dallas Drake behind the net. Drake makes a move against Gilmore, but Gilmore pins him up.
There's going to be a call now.
There is going to be a call. Primo tries to center, and Gilmore touches. And a holding call against Doug Gilmore will give the Red Wings a power play. We're tied. Off, drop pass for Sheppard. He scores!
What a trigger man, Ray Sheppard.
And again, Felix Potvin way back in his crease. And Sheppard goes high. A power play goal makes it 2-1 Detroit.
Took him 33 seconds. Nice play by Coffey to lead this thing off. But Ray Sheppard, boy, can he pull the trigger with the best of them. Sheppard had 32 goals during the year. Coffey got attention up the middle. Dallas Drake to Sheppard as the Leafs sort of peel off. And that puck may have hit. May have hit, rather, Ellett, number four, in front of the net. But Felix Potvin looked like he had problems picking it up. And Sheppard pulled that trigger and makes it 2-1.
Again, Mick, that Red Wing power play that converted nearly 25% of the time of the regular season. 1-for-3 here in game one. Ray Sheppard, the 8th playoff goal he has scored in his career. Here's a chance now for the Leafs. Chevalier with a great stop as it was Andrechuk that walked in. Now Gilmore with the loose puck. He tries a wraparound, but Chevalier steered it aside. And now Eisenbart able to bang it off the near boards to center ice. Bob Probert and Paul Coffey drawing the assist on the power play goal. Here's Fedorov leading a rush into the zone with Konstantinov. Goes to Konstantinov, who circles the Toronto goal. Stuffed it out in front, intercepted by Gilmore, but checked away from him, and a penalty coming to Kozlov. He hooked the arm of Gilmore.
And he held Gilmore from making the play behind the net. And Van Helleman right in the same spot that he made the call against Doug Gilmore a few moments ago. Whistles Vyacheslav Kozlov for hooking, and the Leafs will go to the power play trailing 2-1. See, Van Helleman's in the corner. Gilmore tries to get at the Red Wing player to make the check, and he's hooked back, and his progress was impeded by number 13, and therefore the call, because the puck may have come out in front of the net in the Leafs zone to give him a scoring chance, and therefore Gilmore not being able to get there. Van Helleman's got to make that call.
Incidentally, that assist by Paul Coffey moves him past the great Gordie Howe into the 11th spot on the all-time assist list in Stanley Cup playoff history. Paul Coffey just going to continue to pass people as he continues to play. Red Wings 2, the Maple Leafs 1. Ellett sends it across Krzelnicki. Keeps it off a shot, deflected over top of the net. Racine goes hard around the boards. Gill couldn't hold it in. It's picked up by Burr. He's got a two-on-one with Yzerman. Burr, shot, score! Short-handed goal! And the Red Wings have a two-goal lead.
Well, the puck bounces away from the defenseman at the boards, Todd Gill. And Schonberg looks, he knows he's got Yzerman. The defenseman, Ellett's got to take the pass away and leave the shot to the goaltender. And Burr beats Potvin to the short side with a blast to make it 3-1. Short-handed goal. And there's a happy number 11. Big goal, and more importantly, a two-goal lead now.
Well, near the end of the regular season, Mick, you'll recall a Red Wing game in Tampa Bay where the Wings scored two shorthanded goals, both of them by Yzerman, and both of them were set up by Sean Burr. And that time, Burr, using Yzerman kind of as a decoy, looked at him. And Sean Burr, as you know, when he leans on the stick,
he can fire it. Ellett played it the way he's supposed to, lead the shooter to the goaltender and take away the pass for the open net slam. But Burr just plain beat young Potvin.
50 seconds left in the Kozlov penalty. 12:50 to go in the second period. Red Wings lead the Maple Leafs 3-1 here in game one.
This is in again, and Potvin fortunate to get the pads down on the ice to keep it out.
Sylvain Lebeuve goes back to the Toronto bench. Of course, he came out of the Montreal Canadiens system and played 3 years for Pat Burns.
Potvin out of position. He gets back. He's sort of nonchalant. All of a sudden, whoa, baby. He sees Ray Sheppard, who's already snapped one by him tonight. Down quickly was Potvin to keep the score 3-1.
Yzerman wins the draw cleanly. Iversine wanted to send it across for Cicerelli, but it was knocked away by Burr. Markow back inside the Detroit zone. Gives it off to Racine. Racine's pass. That hit Cecil. Burr flips it back inside the Detroit zone. Racine, Markow goes up the boards. Cicerelli's long pass off of Burr, but recovered by Markow. He'll carry into the Toronto zone. Drop pass for Yzerman. Snaps a shot, trying to go high on the glove side.
Penalty coming to the Leafs, and they'll touch it here to Dave Ellett.
May have hit Dino Cicerelli in the back.
You can hear that one all the way up in the booth here.
Now the Red Wings just look so aggressive and so confident with a man advantage versus last year when it really let them down in the playoffs. Cicerelli knew he was going to get the hit from Jamie McCowan. The Leafs able to clear. Good work that time by the Toronto penalty killing unit. Kayson leading a rush now with a minute left in the Osborne penalty. Kayson rips it in behind Potvin. He decides to let
David, might have been Probert, David. He was right in Potvin's face. And I'll tell you, the key to this play was Paul Coffey skating backwards from the blue line to the red line. He made the play back and then got the puck back at the Leaf blue line to set the whole play up. There's Probert in front. No, he jumped up out of the way and it went right through Felix Potvin's legs to make it 4-1. Look at Probert. He goes to his office. And Potvin cannot see a thing. Reverse angle, look at it. And Probert swoops in front. Watch him jump up. No way the young man can get a handle on where that puck is with big Probert there. And Detroit is a three-goal lead.
First of the playoffs in his ninth career. Playoff goal, Probert with a huge hit on Jamie McCowan.
It's because McCowan and Kennedy, his buddy, came together.
Wendell Clark up the left side. Makes a move on Racine, but he lost the puck now. Pearson tried to center for Wendell Clark, and an excellent defensive play there by Sean Burr. Now McCowan back behind his own net. We'll have to await the official announcement of the penalty coming against Detroit.
Gilmore with a little stab at Konstantinov there. There's going to be Detroit penalty as Andrinov on the ice against the Gilmore line. I'm not sure if that was the cross-check call or not. It wasn't much of a cross-check, maybe interference.
They lead it 4-1. Back to the line, Gil. Moves it to Borshevsky with his back to the boards. Now Borshevsky into the circle. Goes to Gilmore, bouncing puck. Taken away by Markow. To dump it in front, Chevalier held his ground on that left post. 40 seconds left of the penalty. Better off bothering Wendell Clark, knocks it loose. Hides the bar back.
battling against Wendell Clark, and the Wings able to keep it out of their own zone.
Boy, they're just blanket defensing the Leafs right now.
Here's Gilmore. He wants to carry it, and he did, but it is kicked loose by Eisenbart.
White sweaters everywhere, David. They're giving the Leafs to the dose of their own medicine, and that should do it for the chase-on penalty.
On one development, Primo tries to go to the outside, lost control of the puck, moves it to Drake. Play still on. It comes out to Eisenman. Wings have the extra attacker on there. Eisenman behind the net, looking for a wraparound. Picked up shot, score! Mark Howe drives it home on the delayed penalty of the Red Wings with a 5-1 lead.
Boy, Eisenman came off the bench like he was shot out of a cannon. Cheveldayoff, good move by the goaltender to get there. He saw the delayed call. Eisenman got into the play, took it from Drake, came around the front, stuffed the backhander that hit Potvin, and there was Howe to finish it off. Howe down in deep, three Leafs down there. Howe just doesn't back away totally. Came off the skate of Cullen, maybe. Hit the blocker of Potvin, and it's 5-1 Detroit. Potvin follows the play around. It did hit the skate of Cullen. And the Wings get a lucky bounce and cash it in. This continues like this, it could be a long, long third period.
Mark Howe scores the goal. Here is Dallas Drake. Wraparound opportunity didn't get through. The Leafs look to break back. They trail the Red Wings by 4 here in game 1. Berg with a big hit there on Ebrosine. Mark Howe, 37 years old, skating like a 17-year-old. Takes it into the zone, tries to set up Primo, but it's knocked away, and the Leafs clear it ahead for Borjeski. And Potvin turned him aside. Here's a chance for Fedorov. Blocker saved by Potvin. Konstantinov rolls it back in deep. Todd Gill, checked by Fedorov. Kozlov there as well. Kozlov centers. Eisenbart couldn't get to it. Andrejczyk lets it go for Gilmore. Doug Gilmore flips it back for Andrejczyk. He's taken down. Now Borjeski rolls it to the side of the net. Eisenbart flips it ahead. Kozlov is there. Kozlov. Nice outlet pass for Eisenbart. Fedorov leaves it. Eisenbart rolls it across the Toronto zone. Fedorov drops it back for Chiasson. Boy, he almost stuck it in on the short side there from a tough angle. Look at Kozlov. Muscles the puck away from Ellen. Kozlov lost his balance, but rolls it back to Eisenbart. His pass is blocked. Eisenbart gets it back. Kozlov along the board down to the line. Konstantinov broke his stick. Drives a shot. Saved by Potvin. Puck goes to the corner of Kerr.
Grover's going to go. He knocked down Russ. He goes after Mironov. Delayed call. Potvin to the bench, and here comes Cullen.
Cullen across the line. Avoids a check. Cullen into the circle. Gives it off to Gilmore. Backhand pass. And just as time was expiring, there was less than a second as that shot skipped off the stick of Cheveldayoff.
Boy, I'd like to see this one on the clock.
Well, they will review it, I'm sure, to make sure it was in, but
if it is, it gives the Leafs a chance, at least, with some momentum going into the intermission.
Not much question.
And not a big 4 goal, but now only 3, and 3 certainly is a lot of goals, but better 3 than 4, and
Ebrosine, and that one may have been deflected on the way through.
Sure did.
But it's 6-2 in favor of Detroit.
Boy, that was a nice play by Primo to come across the blue line, come in as the trailer, and take the pass and then set up Racine. The puck deflected off a Leaf flare. Here's the pull-up by number 55. Racine goes to the middle. The shot hits Jamie McCowan and ricochets right over the right shoulder of young Potvin to make it a 6-2 hockey game. There's the deflection right off the hip and into the top corner. No chance for the young Leaf goaltender. And the Wings again lead by 4. It's by him before he flinches. Racine will get the goal. Primo, I believe, and Drake will get the assist.
Here's Coffey. Lead pass for Drake, picked up by Primo. Back to Drake. That's a great scoring chance. Now Racine bounces back up.
He's got to be, at the very least, bruised up from that bump. Probert goes after Berg. Gets his attention after a run in the boards. Now Zezo, he'll take a hit from Racine. Berg, number 10, is there for the leaf shot. Berg, for Detroit, comes up with it. He lifts it over everybody's head down the ice. That'll be just wide of Felix Potman's road to the Cup sweepstakes. The second Ellen. Now Borshevsky comes over to play the puck back up the boards. Andrew Chuck with Konstantinov bearing down on him. Konstantinov held it in. Here's Kozlov behind the Toronto net. Moving away from Todd Gill. Gill drags him down. Eisenbart moves it to the near side of the Toronto zone. Dave Ellett has it there. Ellett to center ice for Andrichuk. Andrichuk's pass too far in front of a teammate. Konstantinov easily clears it back. Ellett goes cross ice. Rob Pearson tries to get into the zone. Good hip check there by Chiasson. Now Pearson in the corner. Banks it off the boards for Cullen. He goes back to the line. Lefebvre drives the shot. Scores! It went right through Chevalier. And the Leafs have their third goal of the game. It's a 6-3 Detroit advantage.
I'm not sure if Chevalier was screened on this play. He seemed to go down at the same time the puck was going underneath his pads. And nobody back at that Leaf point. All the Red Wings down in deep. Lefebvre from 50 feet. Rips it. I don't think it touched anybody. It went right underneath Chevalier's pads. We'll get a look at it from behind Sylvain Lefebvre. There's the shot through. No, it dropped a little bit, and as Chevalier's going down, the puck's coming through. It doesn't get the back part of his skates, and it's a 6-3 hockey game with 12:15 to go in the third. Watch the Leaf stick right there come up and catch Nicholas Lidstrom on the left side of the face. He draws blood, and Van Helleman made the five-minute major call. Wow, did he ever catch him with a wicked uppercut with the stick. The bottom part of the left.
Potman, who just got the pants together. Coffey back to the line now. Chiasson back to Coffey. Coffey top of the circle. His pass intended for Eiserman. Ricochets across. Chiasson, good job to hold it in.
You can see Cicerelli in front with Lefebvre. Ooh, boy, are they going at it. They're probably both going to go.
Yeah.
This is where the Red Wings have to use discipline. It's an overused word, yes. Cicerelli, he's John with Potvin, the goaltender. Major chin music going on here, boys. And Lefebvre and Cicerelli just whacking away at each other. Finally, Dino goes down. And we'll see what happens. They're still pushing and shoving down there. The crowd starts the Dino chant.
Away by Osborne. Coffey got back to get a stick on it. Coffey back in the Red Wings zone. Looks to wind the attack up the other way. Off the glove of Osborne. It comes into the Toronto zone. Gallant has it there. He'll take it down to the corner. Gallant up the boards. Eiserman picks it up there. Back for Gallant behind the Toronto net. Gallant backhands it now to Eisenbart. All Eisenbart out to Chiasson. Tees it up. Goes back to Eisenbart. He'll rip a shot. That was blocked in front.
That hurt McCowan right off the knee. That's a way to rip him. The Rocket Man with that big blast.
Here's a steal here by Rouse. Rouse dumps it all the way back into his own zone. 1 minute has gone by in the five-minute time by Howe. Right through. Pop and the save. Sezel skates the puck out of trouble and gets it by Ellett. Now Fedorov and Ellett both overskated. Ellett recovers. Ellett looking for an opening. Goes up the glass. Gilmore met by Mark Howe. Now Lidstrom comes over. Keeps it in the zone for Probert. Probert on the wall. Gives it off to Lidstrom. Lidstrom to Howe. Dumps it back off the near board. Probert tied up by Gill. Ellett goes around the boards. Held in by Mark Howe. Now knocked away by Andrichuk. Big Andrichuk able to clear it for Gilmore. Todd Gill coming up into the play. Shorthanded bid here, and the pass just tipped away by Lidstrom. And the Wings recover with 2 minutes and 20 seconds left in the five-minute major. Lidstrom taken hard into the boards by Todd Gill. Probert gets it to Fedorov. Cross ice, hand for Coffey. Drives a shot, save. Potman. Andrichuk taking his time. Moves it now to Gill. And Todd Gill also taking his time. Now he'll drive it down. Bottom of the circle. Rolls cross ice for Dallas Drake. Drake tries to send it back for Burr. But it's clearing off of his skate as he got turned around. And Sessa will just clear it. Kozlov in deep. Primo wanted to go to Shepard. It deflects out to Racine. He gives it to Shepard. 10 seconds left in the penalty. Cross ice. Shot hit the goalpost. Kozlov one timed it off the goalpost. They'll try it again, but this time the Cowan intercepts. Fave serving the 5 minutes. Major, and he comes out.
Look at that. Kozlov working traffic.
Under 7 minutes to go. Red Wings with a 3-goal advantage. Konstantinov takes a rough ride from Gilmore. Barkow. He's got Fedorov coming late toward the net. Here's how snaps a shot. Hot man. Again, down on that crouch. Makes the save. Red Wing. A wraparound attempt by Borshevsky. Konstantinov was there to close it off. And Kozlov gives it to Fedorov now. Three-man rush, but Fedorov's pass too far in front of Izavard, who took a shoulder from Dmitry Mironov, number 15. Bizon drives it back in.
Straighten that out next time back. There it is, right there.
There it is. He got the stick up on Mironov as well, but he got away with it.
Yes, he did.
Now Kozlov pulls it out of the crowd, but Borshevsky intercepts. He backhands it off of Zezel deep into the Toronto zone. Zezel along the end board. He'll take a hit from Bob Probert as the puck deflects out to center ice. Osborne has it there. He snaps it across in front of Chevalier. Sean Burr back to recover the loose puck. And Burr easily will.
Look at that Coffey move up into the play.
Clear it out for Coffey. Coffey drop pass for Kennedy. Kennedy, nice move against Lefebvre. Rolls it out in front. Berg in good defensive position for the Leafs. Stops it. Clears it ahead now. So shot. Pop fail the save. Loose in front between the circles and recovered by Cullen. John Cullen. Very nifty in traffic. Able to work his way loose.
Look out. Baby. Holy smoke. Konstantinov with the old-fashioned hip check on Wendell Clark and a bit of a sucker pass up the middle. Clark got his head down to take the pass. And Clark's going to get a penalty for roughing on Chiasson. It'll close the door on all of this with inside a minute to go.
By Chevalier, he steers into the corner. Now Coffey rolls it back behind his own net. Yves Racine will get it there. Racine tied up by Osborne. Ray Shepard drops it back down for Coffey. 10 seconds on the clock. Red Wings in no hurry. Coffey will go back behind his own net. And the players will be content to let it run out. Come off the bench to congratulate their goaltender, Tim Chevalier, as the Red Wings win game one.